What is unfair about the prize money at Wimbledon?
Yes. They only give it to you if you're really, really good at tennis.
That is damnably unfair.
Nothing.
Really?
Not anymore.
Very fair.
Is this still unfair?
Yeah, it's still unfair. Women get more money for playing than men.
Yeah. Oh, per set, you mean? You're talking about
men play a lot more tennis and get less money. Yeah, I'll show you how it goes. When it started in 1884, the ladies' champion won a 20-guinea silver flower basket. Aww. while the men got a 30-guinea gold trophy. By 2006, 625,000 for Amélie Mauresmo, who played 142 games, versus just £30,000 more for Roger Federer, who played 202 games. And the best women were earning more than the best men because their shorter matches allowed them to compete in both doubles tournaments as well as the singles. The rate per game told the story. 2005, the final eight women earned an average of £1,432 per game against the men's 993.
How much do they win now if they win?
It's equal for the first prize. The women's champion gets the same prize as the men's champion, but the men's champion plays a lot more tennis.
No, but be fair, the women have got to come off and make the tea as well.
And women get more from sponsorship.
And also, half a million, that's not that much when you think 50% will go to tax, 15% will go to their agent, then they've got to buy all their balls, and they've got to buy the sticky stuff, the wrap around the racket. That's very expensive.
So do the men.
Then it's the South Fields, they've got to get a travel card. That's
so do the men.
They're left with about £1.50 after all that.
Anyway, now that male and female tennis players get the same prize money, it's arguably unfair to men who work harder and longer for less money overall.